In today's video, we're going to talk about using Lighthouse in Cypress automation testing. So before we start, let's give some introduction about what are some factors that impacts the user experience on a web page the most. So what we found is the speed it takes to load a page affects 75% of users. We also found that how easy it is to find what you're looking for affects 66% of users. We found that how well the screen of the site fits within your screen, for example, if you're using mobile, desktop, or iPads or tablets, affects 61% of users. We also found that how simple the site is also affects 58% of the users. How attractive the site looks affects 24%. And so next, let's talk about Lighthouse and how that affects what we're looking at. Lighthouse performs a series of audits on a web page. It simulates real-world scenarios on various devices and network conditions, and then generates a report with scores and detailed information on different aspects of the page. Some of the metrics includes it evaluates the page load speed, time to interact, the accessibility for different types of users with disabilities, the adherence to best practices, and other features like offline support and installation capabilities. It has become a valuable tool for web developers and website owners who want to ensure the websites are optimized and accessible and user-friendly. Lighthouse is an open source tool and a part of the Google Developer Tools Suite. It is designed to improve the quality and performance of web pages by providing audits, insights, and diagnostics. Lighthouse can be used to test web pages against a set of best practices, performance metrics, and other guidelines to assess their overall quality and identify areas for improvement. The primary focus of Lighthouse is on web performance, accessibility, progressive web app compliance, best practices, and search engine optimization factors. It generates comprehensive reports with actionable recommendations to help developers optimize their websites and create a better user experience for their visitors. So, how do you get Lighthouse? Well, first, use npm install cypress-lighthouse to install the package. And then you can update your Cypress config file by adding these lines for Lighthouse. And then later we'll show you how we add these lines into our config file. But essentially you're requiring Lighthouse here, and then you're also registering the Lighthouse task here and preparing the browser for the Lighthouse audits later on as well. So a chaining component with results of the Lighthouse audit in tests. So this is an example. You would import the Lighthouse commands, and then you would configure it using these right here. I just wanted to add that if we go back to this page, these are actually the cutoffs that you set for Lighthouse. And so for example, this is the cutoff for metrics. So if it gives a score less than 80, then it won't pass. And this is a cutoff for accessibility. So we require 100 score for accessibility, and so on for best practices, SEO, and so on. We'll all show you this a little bit later on in the video when we implement this into our code. So now I'm going to show you how you can set up your own Cypress Lighthouse program within your own project. So before I start editing some code, the first thing I have to do is I have to install npm Lighthouse. And so for what you can do is you can go ahead and you can run this command, npm install Cypress Lighthouse. And you can go ahead and follow the instructions and install it. For me, if you are similar to me and you had some issues with it, you can just force by using the force tag. And this might create some vulnerabilities within your packages. But for the purpose of this tutorial, I'm just going to do that for now. And next, what you can do is you can go to your cypress.config.json file, .javascript file, and what you'll do is you'll insert a few lines so that you can run Lighthouse. And so I'm going to go ahead and put that line of code right here, and it'll be basically using Lighthouse, and will require this Lighthouse right here. The next thing that you have to do is under setup node events, you have to paste some code over. And so let me go ahead and do that. Basically, you have to paste these lines of code here, which basically use Lighthouse, and then before a browser launch, It'll allow you to do a bunch of things, and basically it registers Lighthouse tasks and it prepares the browser for Lighthouse audits. Once you have these in your config file, you can go ahead and create your own Lighthouse script. So right here, I'm going to create a new script and I'm going to name it lighthouse.cy.js. And then in this script, I can now write some code. So the first line will be importing the package. So I'm going to go ahead and write import cypress-audit lighthouse-commands. And then once I have that, now I can go ahead and write some code. So first I'm going to start with describe, and then this will be Cypress test using Lighthouse. Now after that, I'm going to write my first function, which basically will be Lighthouse check scores on Google. And so basically I'll be running Lighthouse on the Google homepage to see how it performs. And then, so I'll do this once uncaught exception. I have false. And then I will do, I'll visit the Google website. And so I'll have https://www.google.com. And then once I visit that website, I will now set some metrics that I will have in order for the test to pass. And so now you can basically set the cutoffs. And so I'm just going to paste it over because there's quite a bit to write. But you just do cypress.lighthouse, and then you just write, so I want performance to be at least an 80 score, accessibility to be at least an 85, best practices 95, SEO 75, and then some of these other things. And so for this, since we're using Google, this should be very optimized. And so this should pass. I'm going to add a second test to show you what it would look like if it fails. So I'm going to go ahead and write. I'm going to go ahead down here and I'm going to go write it. Lighthouse. Check scores on golf page. And I'm going to do again, psi once, uncaught exception. Site.visit. So this will be the base home URL, which we set in our page as this golf page on this ADM Lucid website. And so in order to get to the golf page, which was what we want to test, we're going to do a series of commands, basically. The first is we're going to use site.contains to find the button that contains test. Click that. We're going to use contains to find a button that contains golf underscore course and click that even if it's not visible by using the force is equal to true tag. Now after that, now we're going to do the same thing. So I'm going to go ahead and paste over some metric cutoffs for Lighthouse. So paste that over. Basically, we require 80 performance, 85 accessibility, 95 best practices, SEO, PDW, and so on. So now I can go ahead and save this. And in order to run this, I'll just run npx. I'll just run npx cypress open. And there's some issue with the config file right here. And so let me go see what the problem is. So I'm going to open up the config file right here. And we see that we're having some issues with this line right here. So it seemed like there was a dependency issue for that Lighthouse package. And so I wasn't able to figure it out. So I actually resetted my project and I did a new project and I wrote the code into a different project. And I have the same code here. I'm using the Cypress Lighthouse and I just used npm Lighthouse installation. And I have the same code for this right here. exact same everything. And this time when I run, I should be able to see that it works. So I'm gonna go ahead and run npx cypress open. And this time it'll open a browser and I'll go ahead and click E2E testing. I'll use Chrome. And I'm just gonna minimize these two so you can see the one we wanna run. We wanna run Lighthouse. And within this, it'll basically test, for example, in the first test, we're testing Google. So it's testing it through different browser settings. For example, this would probably be for something like a mobile device or something. And it'll test different sizes of it as well. It'll also test the golf page, which is this page on this website. And so it's going to test a variety of different metrics, for example, accessibility, SEO, and load time, and so on. And so give it some time to run. And here, it's all done. So if I go back to Google, as expected, everything passed. It was able to meet all of the metrics that we set in Lighthouse. And so we didn't get any errors here. And so example for right here, it says that the performance record is 90 and the threshold we set was 80. Accessibility was 90, threshold was 85. Best practices 100, threshold was 95. But if we go to our golf page on the other hand, we see that it doesn't meet the threshold that we set. Accessibility was 78, best practices 75, SEO was 74, but these thresholds were set as much higher, and so it didn't pass and it gave us an assertion error. And so that's basically how you can use Lighthouse to perform accessibility testing on your own website. And this is the code that we have. It's very simple, it's very easy to do. If you found this video helpful, please give this video a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for listening. Look forward to seeing you next time.